GroupChat in Microsoft Teams is a great way to collaborate between friends and co-workers on a multitude of topics. But what are the best practices and what handy tips can we learn? As we know, Microsoft Teams provides us with a host of ways to collaborate with our co-workers and friends. Imagine this. Constant chat. Chat that you can go back and look at historically. Not just between you and one person, but in a group. Enter GroupChat, everybody. GroupChat is a way that Microsoft Teams brings people together and then lets everybody in on the party that you've been having in GroupChat. What do I mean by that? Let's select a person here, Irvin Sayers. We're going to say hello to Irvin, and he'll instantaneously get notified that there's a chat requiring his attention. It'll pop up, no worries. Now, with that being said, we can start a conversation with him. And then what we can do is we can then add somebody else into the conversation. So, we'll add in Nestor. Right, Nestor will be added in, add, there you go, straight away. All of a sudden, we've got two people who we're collaborating with within a chat window. No dramas there, I hear you say. Well, this is indeed group chat. And what you can do is you can select whether you want new additions into this chat just to have access to recent chat or to chat that's been back historically. Couldn't be easier adding people into chat. Now you'll notice at the top center of the screen where the names are, that there's a little icon of a pencil. This means we can now call this chat something meaningful. Well, as you see, I've put Khaleesi and Daenerys Targaryen, played by Emilia Clarke, in the chat window as a form of a GIF. So we're going to name this a conversation about Game of Thrones. Just so that people know exactly what it is. And here's the entire point, right? Naming your conversations within group chat can allow you to look when you get chat sprawl and team sprawl. It'll enable you to see easily what you're talking about. What's the topic of that chat? Do I need to go in there? Do I really need to stop my sales meeting and look at what's been going on last night in Game of Thrones? Perhaps not. Perhaps you have a spare 5 minutes. It's totally up to you. Getting into the habit, and here's a top tip here for Teams, that if you start to name your conversations, your group chats, it makes it more easily to be searchable, easier for people to know what it's about, and instantaneously I'll go in there and get a little bit of context. Couldn't be easier, right? Group chat is a fantastic way of bringing everyone together or people who you want to collaborate together within this collaboration hub, and Microsoft Teams does it fantastically. So, we've got a conversation running on, mostly a bit one-sided. I can also at-mention particular people in a conversation, so they get notified that they've been at-mentioned in a particular conversation. Now, again, we're all Game of Thrones fans here. So, at-mentioning Nesta and at-mentioning the other percipient within this conversation will notify them that they need to look at this conversation. Now, I know we're talking about Game of Thrones. It could be our sales topic. It could be something about HR. It could be about something about redundancies. It could be the company picnic. It could be anything. But it really is flexible on how you can communicate with each other. Now, a bit of dragon fire. Everyone likes a little bit of that. And GIFs are indeed fantastic and can be added in or taken off. You can also add in praise if you're talking to a group of people and you feel you want to praise them, along with the general subjects of adding news sections. You can add in schedules. You can add in a Wikipedia link as well. All these things can be added into the group chat as if it was an individual channel. And think of it as that, a little personal, separate, minute little channel where you can talk about an acute subject. So, okay, let's go on to YouTube. Let's type in what you want to add it to the chat. We'll install the YouTube add-in so we can go out and bring a YouTube video directly into this group chat. And we'll say, oh, I don't know, www.gameofthrones or something like that. Here's our video, particularly on topic about the Season 8, Episode 6 serious Q&A and what's going on there. Brilliant. That will then be added into the chat as well. And can be added in as a tab. So when we go to our chat, we'll see that there's a YouTube link there that is pointing directly to that video. Think about it other ways. Hey, you can add videos in, for example, if you're working within healthcare. These are the new ways of putting people in the recovery position. It's on YouTube, link it in. If you're operating Microsoft Stream, which is Microsoft's corporate version, like of a video platform, you can put your corporate videos onto Stream, lock it all down, get people away from looking around different intranets and things and put it directly into a chat or a channel. It really is a very powerful function using the visual medium. And they say that people process pictures and video 60,000 times quicker than they do words. So they say, you know, hey, a picture speaks 1,000 words. In fact, it's actually 60,000 words. And that's been shown by a study. How sad am I? Now, if I want to add somebody else in, I can choose if they just come into it right now and don't see any historic data, or they can see historic data as well. That's gone back historically all the way through since the beginning of the chat. Imagine if you were creating a chat about onboarding somebody to a particular project, or this chat was going on between project managers because on a particular topic, and a new project manager came in. Well, you could help their onboarding process by having this historical chat displayed within this group chat. How cool would that be? You could say, hey, you know what? Take 10 minutes, take 20 minutes, take an hour. Get up to speed on what's been going on in the group chat. You'll see all what's been going on. Once you've read that, we can talk about it. And then people can then collaborate within the group chat, particularly in context. I think it's great. And of course, you've got other multimedia add-ins at the bottom, as you have with other channels as well. For example, this full text editor that you can put in, use bold, italic, and really make your text and statements stand out, along with meetings requests as well, where you've got that full text editor in there. And you can have meetings and select where you want your meetings to be held, whether you want them in a particular channel or not. How cool is that? So it's a little bit about group chat, a little bit about best practices for Microsoft Teams in group chat as well. Naming your group chats is great. Gives it a bit of context. People know what they're going to be jumping into, whether it's Game of Thrones, the latest workforce reduction program, what's going on at the company picnic, the Christmas do, you name it. Name it whatever you want. But be certain to the fact is, if you don't, that's going to lead to confusion. And with an ever-increasing sprawl of Microsoft Teams within this collaboration hub, you have to be contextual with what you do. And that way, then, people are not going to get frustrated. You're going to drive adoption. And with driving adoption, people are going to collaborate more. People collaborate more, theoretically, they'll be happier. They'll be taking the SH out of IT, as I put it. And they'll be more productive. Anyway, I've been the Collaboration Kernel. Thanks very much for watching. This has been a little bit about group chat, as we mentioned, naming group chat and some top tips. Check back for some more videos in the series and check out the back catalogue as well. See you soon and happy collaborating.